If you're an organization or jurisdiction looking to train and exercise your ability to respond to earthquakes, it's helpful to take a step back and think about what type of scenario would I be dealing with if an earthquake were to take place? What's the magnitude? Where would it impact? What type of critical infrastructure might be taken offline if an earthquake were to impact my community? Thinking about it this way allows you to think about all the different resources and capabilities that you may need to bring to bear in order to mitigate these issues that impact your community, from critical transportation, critical infrastructure issues, and everything in between. It's important to think through the entirety of the process when looking to train and respond to an earthquake scenario. You don't have to start big. You can start small with drills and small tabletop exercises to help you prepare for what actions you may take if an earthquake were to ever impact your community. Once you start with those small drills and exercises, you can move up to something more robust, like an operational level exercise or even a full-scale exercise to help you refine the response and coordination needed during an earthquake response.
First and foremost is just to understand your risk, and FEMA's National Risk Index is a great visualization and map of your hazards in your area. And so you can really visualize and see the risk in your area, including earthquakes. And then once you understand your risk, a natural step is to start preparing for that. And that can take the shape of just a simple conversation with your family, your friends, the people that you live with about, you know, what would you do in the event that an earthquake strikes? You know, how are you going to communicate with one another? And then in the event that the communication systems are down, you know, maybe thinking about creating a rendezvous point for you guys to meet up. FEMA also has a wealth of resources on their ready.gov website where you can download resources or checklists. And then if you have the means and the time, some other actions that you can take are protecting your household items and securing them, whether that's, you know, a bookshelf or making sure that there's nothing hanging over your bed, or creating an emergency supply kit, whether that's for your home, for your car, or for your workplace. And then last, but and certainly the most costly option, is to retrofit your household. Building codes are one of the most effective ways to mitigate against earthquake risk. And the National Institute of Building Sciences actually came out with a study that said, for every dollar that you invest in earthquake mitigation, you save on average $12. And those savings really come through the adoption of the current building codes.
On the West Coast and throughout all of the United States, earthquakes are a real danger that we need to be prepared for, and especially with the fire service, we need to be able to respond after the fact. And if you have not done drills, if you have not practiced, if you have not developed a robust communications network to back up what inevitably is going to go down during an earthquake, then you need to get to work and make it a priority to develop those systems and prepare for the upcoming inevitable earthquake.
So I've talked a lot about organizations and jurisdictions' response to earthquake, but what can I do as an individual to protect myself and my family during a possible earthquake scenario? The most important thing is to understand that responders may not be able to get to you right away. So have a plan, have a kit, make sure that you're prepared for the risk that you may face in an earthquake.